A moment of meditation, joy of Zion Church. Let's confess together. I am a spirit. I have a soul. I live in a body. I am a new creation. God loves me. God blesses me. God makes me righteous. God gives me peace that the world cannot give. I am grateful. I am thankful. I am delighted. I am happy. I am joyful. I am okay. I am doing good. In Christ, I am a person with overwhelming confidence to win in any situation and circumstance. I am a victor, not a victim. In Christ, I am a person who has the ability to control my inner climate, regardless of external circumstances. I am a spirit having the spirit. In Christ, I am a person who has the ability to maintain a positive attitude in a negative situation. I am blessed to be a blessing. I will never, never, never be the same again. You are the object of His love. The fruit of the righteous is a tree of life, and he that winneth souls is wise. Proverbs chapter 11, verse 30. What God cares about the most in the earth is the souls of men. The Bible says in John chapter 3, verse 16, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." He loved the world of humans, not things. We are the object of His love. Each one of us is more important to Him than the planets and galaxies. He's got angels that supervise the galaxies, and angels appointed over other matters. But the angels with the most honorable job are the ones appointed over people, over the souls for whom Jesus died. When you understand this as a Christian, especially as one who has a cell or care group of fellowship in the local church, your premium will be on people. You might say, "I only have 3 people in my fellowship," but as small as that number might seem, you are more important to God than the one who's put in charge of the environment and all the infrastructure in any particular planet or continent. A cell leader in the house of God has more value in God's book of honors than one who's not born again but might be politically in charge of a whole nation. Read the words of Jesus in Mark chapter 8, verses 36-37. "For what shall it profit a man if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul?" This means the whole world, all of the cosmos, doesn't compare to the value of one soul. The value of a soul is the blood of Jesus. If you were the only person on the face of the earth, Jesus would have still come to die for you. He didn't come because we were many. He came because we were valuable to God. That's why God isn't willing that anyone should perish. If anyone goes to hell, it isn't because God wanted him or her to go to hell. He's done everything to stop man from going to hell, and he'll do everything to stop them. The only thing is, he can't decide for you, because he gave you a very important gift, the ability to make decisions, the right to choose. And in his love, he went ahead to tell you what to choose: life in Christ. 1 John chapter 5, verse 11. Prayer. Dear Father, thank you for your love that's so real and so divine, and by which you are demonstrated to me my true value through the price you paid for my salvation. I rejoice exceedingly, knowing that I'm worth the precious blood of Jesus Christ. I go all out today, reaching out to souls with the good news of Christ's love and saving power. In Jesus' name, amen. I hope so much Jesus be inside you and covers you today. Have a glorious day or have a glorious night. See you tomorrow.